factoring was greatest common factor. Now we're going to factor.
Yeah.
Quadratic.
Oh no.
Trinomials. What does that mean?
There's exponent was two and three terms.
The exponent's going to be two, and there's going to be three terms. It's going to look like this: ax squared plus bx plus c. That's
oh my gosh.
So we're going to start with this, and our goal will be to get into two parentheses. This is called factored form.
Is this the hardest part?
This is part one of part two.
Really?
You
know
what I mean? So part two is going to be harder then. But essentially the process will be the same. So, number one. X squared plus 5x plus 6. Okay, we're going to go ahead and lay out the parentheses. And our goal is to take that and divide it in its two factors. First thing I always like to write down is my x's. Do you agree that x times x would be x squared?
Yes.
Okay,
so,
just like
so you can always check it and refoil it. So far we have x squared if we were to go foil. We got the f. Now I'm going to actually skip to the last part. I'm going to look at this number. What times what is 6?
2 and 3.
2 times 3. 2, 3. Write a plus and a plus.
Dude,
let's keep going with the check. It'd be x times 3, 3x.
Wow.
2 times x, 2x. And then 2 times 3,
no.
6.
No.
Would that turn back into that?
Yes, so you're basically
yes.
just reversing the foil method.
Yes,
yes, Brandon.
You're unfoiling, if you will.
I don't know.
So, I want to explain something really quick to explain why you've been doing these. Because what you just did has been this, just in a different form. You've just been practicing what times what and making sure it adds up. This number went on the top, so 6, which is your C value. It's the number at the end, your constant.
Really? We've been prepping for this all week.
The number on the bottom, 5. This is your B value. It's the number in between. So you did this. Not even knowing that it would apply to this. You thought to yourself, what times what is 6? 2 times 3, and then you wrote it in here, and you got the answer.
No.
Wow.
Number 2.
Good job.
Wow. That gives me a little hope.
X squared plus 3x. I hope it does, because it's going to get harder. Because
I'm fine with that.
Hey, y'all.
But you have this at the root, and you know how to handle it. So let's say we think of this. I'm going to visualize the x. I'm going to say, what goes at the top of the x?
Negative
18. What goes at the bottom? 3. So you're going to look at the top of the x first. What times what is 18? What's out there?
6 and 3.
3 times 2 times 9.
9 times 2. Do I want that one?
No.
Which one do I want?
3 times 3 negative 6.
3 times 6. Which one gets the negative?
Negative 3. Or
3.
6.
3.
No, negative
3.
3.
Negative 3 plus 6 would turn into a positive 3. So there we go. X and X, negative 3, and positive 6. Question, would it be right if I also wrote this as the answer, in case you did that on your paper?
Yes.
You wrote the 6 over here and the 3 over here. Does that matter?
Perfectly.
What property is that?
Commutative property of multiplication.
So either one of those answers will work. Number... questions so far?
Not even.
Y squared minus 7y minus 44. I'm going to lay out my parentheses. Y, and I'm going to look at the 44 first. I'm not going to write the x out this time, so I just want to visualize it. What times what is 44? I'm looking at the top.
11 and 4.
Double check. Is 11 minus 4 or 4 minus 11 7?
Yes.
Which one gets the negative?
11.
I've got a cheat to show you. Okay?
How did you get 11 again?
What times what is 44? So you got to think of what multiples of 44 are there.
Oh,
11 and 4.
Factor, excuse me,
and 4.
Wait,
11 and 4, that's
right. So, here's my cheat. This is what we have so far. If you have a positive here, and a positive here, what do the signs have to be?
Positive.
If you've got a negative here, what do the signs have to be?
One negative, one positive.
This one tells you the bigger number gets that positive. So 6 gets the positive. Which one got the negative on this one? 11, because it's bigger.
The second sign,
because you always look at the last number first, tells you what types of signs. This first sign tells you what they're going to be. Which one gets which? All right, number 4.
So what do you do with the 7?
What do you do with the 7? Here's
the 7. I know the 11 and 4 is 44.
Okay, here's your 7. So if I check this and I do FOIL, Y times Y, Y squared. You good so far? Yes? Then I'm going to do Y times 4. 4Y. Then I'm going to do negative 11 times Y, negative 11Y. What's 4 minus 11?
Oh my gosh.
It's hiding. It's not going to be in your final answer. Right there. So you can always do your check to make sure that you pick the right numbers.
I understand that.
So how do you tell which?
Wait, now I really understand that.
Woo!
The first
All right.
The
x is v squared minus 10v plus 21.
What do you mean, like? If the 7 would be positive, then that means the bigger 4 would have been negative.
Okay, Samuel, I guess we're going to go see an Indiana.
So I want everybody to look where first?
21.
21. What
Keith
times what is 21?
Toby Keith.
7 and 3. And it's positive, but this
Keith
is negative.
Yeah.
So what does that tell you about the signs?
Both are going to be negative.
They're both negative. So,
are you going with
V minus 7, V minus 3. Does it matter which order you wrote it in?
Nope.
Done. Easy.
Do you have to wear it like that?
Yeah, we got to wear this official dress.
Wait, pause it.
Oh, shit.